We have been studying light. We've been studying how a light source emits light in all directions. Any particular direction can be noted by a ray or a beam of light. We are going to use a light box to see how we can make the rays and see the propagation of light through different materials or reflect from surfaces. A light box is a very simple device. It contains a light, it is covered black from all sides, then it has a ray maker. A ray maker is just a flat, opaque sheet of plastic with vertical slits. When you place this ray maker and the light box assembly on any flat sheet, because the rays that are touching or the light that is grazing along the surface of the paper, that is going to light up and they will show up as rays. These act as ray maker, and we can study using this apparatus what will happen to the rays when they encounter other surfaces that are placed here. This is a planar convex surface, biconvex thick lens. This is also biconvex thinner than this one, biconcave lens. These are all prisms, the three of them here, but the angles are different. This is an equilateral prism, right angle prism, rectangular slab. Then we have another prism, glass prism, which is an equilateral prism, curved surface, which can either be used as concave or convex. This is with another radius of curvature, convex on this side, concave on the other. We have a small device which is rough on one side and has a mirror which is highly polished on the other. We will use these to study what happens to light when it is incident on any of these surfaces. When I switch this on, you can see a parallel beam of light. These can be taken as rays, and we can study the effect for reflection and refraction. As I bring this plane surface in the path of this parallel beam, you can see the reflected rays are also parallel. However, if we use this other side, which is rough, the reflection is not regular and it is diffused. I'm going to move this mirror at an inclination, and you can see that as soon as this edge is released, the parallel light goes straight without any reflection. So, reflection will occur as soon as the beam or the ray of light is incident on any reflecting surface. You can see the effect of what happens when you change the angle of plane surface. This is a case of regular reflection. However, one more thing is to be noted, that the reflected rays are not as intense as the incident ones, because some light is absorbed. Now we are going to take a curved surface, taking the inside here, which is our concave surface. See how the reflected rays go. They converge to a point, and beyond that they diverge. This particular point is your focus. So, parallel beam incident on a curved surface focuses at a point after reflection, then the reflected rays move beyond. If we change the curvature of this mirror, the point of focus also changes. There is nothing to stop these rays. They would go ahead, but they would be reflected from the surface, meet up at a point, converge to that point, and beyond the point they diverge again. What would happen if we use a convex surface. Notice how the rays diverge. And they don't meet at any real point. But these diverging rays seem to be coming from a point behind the mirror. This is a case of convex mirror or a convex surface, and a parallel beam of light is falling on it. So, parallel beam can be rendered converging or diverging just after reflection from a surface. Let us now study what happens if light passes through transparent medium. The way we enclose the medium is very important and relevant. Here I have a parallel sided rectangular block. Nothing seems to be happening because we've got the edges perpendicular to the parallel beam. But observe what happens when we change this angle. The parallel beam is laterally displaced. That means the entire thing seems to have shifted to one side. Can you think of what are these tiny rays that we can see here? They are of low intensity, but they are on account of some reflection which is taking place at the surface. So, at any surface, some reflection will take place. Some of it would transmit if it is a transparent surface, such as this one. This refraction will change the moment we change the shape of this transparent block. This is a triangular shape. Watch this effect. Parallel beam deviated, not displaced, but deviated from its track. It makes an angle with the original direction. If we change the refracting surface, we can deviate the rays in any other direction. Another shape of triangular prism is this one. It is a scalene triangle. All angles are different. And this is how the refraction would take place. If you change the refracting surface, one interesting result can be seen by using a right angle prism. You can turn the parallel beam by an exact 90 degrees. Watch this effect. So, the angle of deviation here is 90 degrees. The beam was earlier going parallel to the long side of this paper and now it is perpendicular here. Another interesting effect is, if you allowed it to be incident on this long hypotenuse, then the beam is rendered parallel to it again. That means there is a deviation of 180 degrees and it is also displaced. These properties are used in a large number of light effects. What if the shape of the transparent medium had a curved surface, such like in this case, there are two convex surfaces and the same perspex is enclosed in it. Notice the parallel beam focuses at a point and then goes beyond. That means it converges and then diverges beyond the point of focus. The thickness and curvature of the curved surface matters. How the focus has changed now? It is much closer. to the lens surface, you can take a comparison again. What would happen if you had two concave surfaces? When you generate a biconcave lens, something like this. Watch the beam being diverged after refraction. These rays are never going to meet, and they appear to come from a point on the side from where the light is coming. Therefore, there is a virtual focus. What if we combine both these together? The effect of one is cancelled by the other, and the net effect is that there is no converging or diverging. Using a planar convex lens, you get a point of focus. What would happen if you reverse the sight? The focus changes. So, the radius of curvature on the side from where the light is entering and from where it is emerging is important to talk about where the light would converge, or in effect, where you will get the focus point. One interesting effect is getting a spectrum. And if we keep a prism in its path, you can see the spectrum. The white light splits into seven colors. These are some of the amazing effects of reflection and refraction. So, the light box is very useful. It helps us understand the way light propagates on reflection or refraction. We saw that even when laws of reflection were followed, the reflection from plane and curved surfaces produce different effects. We also saw that the effect of refraction through perspex pieces changed because of its shape. What happened in the case of a glass slab was different from what it happened in the case of a lens or in the case of a triangular piece.